Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about the topic the spoken and written language in this class. Before going into the topic, I would like to explain to you what is called as a language. We have discussed so much about what a language is. A language is a structured system of communication. So communication is nothing but we are trying to convey message from one person to other. That is what we call it as a communication is. A language is a broader sense and it is a method of communicating that which involves the use of particular human languages. So the language is being mainly used by whom? It is mainly used by the humans. So a system of communication used by a particular country or a community. So the language we use mainly for the purpose of communication, and it is used in the group of a country or in a particular community. So language is used mainly to inform others or to ask them or to do certain things and to express their feelings, emotions, ideas, informations, etc. So you all know for what all the purpose we are using the languages. So this is what all about the language. And if you are going to study the language in the scientific method, we call it as a linguistics. In this slide, we are going to see the aspects of written and spoken language. So first of all, I would like to tell you what is called as a written language and a spoken language. See, as we have already discussed, the language consists of many symbols and that we use in the form of writing. See, we have seen already the language is considered as both the knowledge and skill. For many persons, it will be only a skill, but for many personalities, it will be a knowledge. So when we come under the concept called skill, spoken English plays a spoken language plays a vital role. But when we talk about the knowledge of the particular person, on the aspects of language, it deals with the written language. The language that we write to make others understand, when they read, when they understand, that is called as what? That is called as written language. And the language that is spoken directly, that is called as spoken language. This both languages has a common characteristics is that in this both written language or the spoken language, we are trying to convey message to others. We are going to communicate what is our idea to others. So this is the difference, or not the difference, this is what is called as spoken language and the written language. The language that is written is called as written language. The language that is spoken is called as a spoken language. See, there are common aspects between both the languages. The written language is a planned one. Because when we start writing something, we will usually plan what we are going to write. But in the case of spoken language, it is entirely different because it is unplanned one. Because when you are going to communicate with your friend, you will not plan everything and talk in front of them. Am I right? So that is unplanned one. Whereas the written language is an organized one. Organized, this is the manner we have to write. For example, if you are going to write a letter to a collector, you will have a certain pattern or certain manner and the method of writing. Am I right? So this is what is called as organized. But spoken language is less organized. You will talk as it comes to you. But only when you talk to the higher authorities or when you talk to your elder ones, you will have some respectful words. But when you talk to your friends, it will be very, very easier to communicate. And the spoken language is very interactive. It will help us to interactive. And whereas the written language is transactional. So this is the major aspects of written language and the spoken language. Characteristics of spoken languages. So spoken language is nothing but the language that you are trying to speak with somebody else. That is what it is called as a spoken languages. So all the language that we write, then we call it as a written language.
So here there are few characteristics about the spoken languages, and we are going to see that. The first point is that repeating, first draft status, vocabulary, grammar, intonation, variation in speed, loudness or quietness, gesture, body language, stress, rhythms, passing and phrases. So this all are the important characteristics of a spoken language. Let us see one by one. Repeating in the sense, we can talk continuously to somebody else. Again and again, we will be able to talk with them. So that we can call it as the aspect of repeating. First draft status means something having coherency, or that we are trying to tell to them in the manner of story. So that is what is called as first draft status. Whereas for the spoken language, vocabulary plays a very, very vital role. So vocabulary plays a vital role, whereas grammar also is very, very important. But in case of writing, grammar plays very vital role. But in the case of spoken languages, it has an importance. But at the same time, as like written language, it does not play that much importance is not necessary for spoken language. If you are not very sure with the grammar also, you can talk the language. For example, you take your mother tongue. You are starting to speak your mother tongue from the age of 2 years or 2.5 years old. Whether the kid is knowing all the grammar and whether the kid is able to deliver the language? No, not at all. So grammar does not play a very vital role for spoken language, but it is important. Okay. The next point is that intonation. Intonation is nothing but the rising and the falling of the voice in speech. So when we are going to convey something, we need to have the rising and the falling tones to convey message to others. So that is what is called as intonation, is a very important characteristic of a spoken language. And variation in speed, right? So we should have variation in the spoken languages. The language can either be very louder. The spoken language, this concept will be followed. It will sometimes be very louder. For example, if you are going to talk in front of a 50 number of people are there, all together some 50 members are there. In front of them, when you are going to talk, you will talk louder. But when only two are communicating, how your voice will be? It will be very low. So this is what is another important characteristic for a spoken language. The next one is that gesture body language. What is called as gesture body language? The body language is very, very important for a spoken language. Whereas in the case of written language, this is not at all necessary. Stress should be there. What is called as stress? Where you have to give stress, you have to give stress, because only then what we are trying to convey will be, the others will be able to understand. Okay. Rhythms is also very important. Passing and phrases is also important. Phrases is nothing but is expressed. So something that you express by using the words. So you are going to express something, that also should be there. So these are the major characteristics of a spoken language. Now we are going to see about the characteristics of a written language. As we have discussed already, what is called as written language? See, written language is nothing but the language that we write, the text that you read, the dictionary that you use, the books that we read, everything is in the form of a written language. And sometimes we used to write letters also to communicate what we are thinking to others. So as like spoken language, written language is also having certain characteristics. The first characteristics that we are going to see about the written language is that final draft status. Whereas in the spoken language, we have seen the first draft status. So first draft status is nothing but it is going to be in a story manner that we are going to convey. But final draft status means it should have completion. It should be completed. For example, your examination is a final draft status, where you have to write everything and you have to complete within the 3 hours. So this is the major and important characteristics of a written language. Density of the content. For example, what you are trying to convey, that matter should be very clear and crisp in the
written language. But in case of spoken language, we can make the person to understand what we are trying to convey. But in the written language, only if the content is going to be correct, we will be able to convey. So grammar plays very, very vital role, because if there is some grammatical errors, the meaning of the sentence will entirely change, because the person who is going to read the written language cannot explain everything. Okay, once you are going to write something, you should be very clear with the grammar. And next one is the social rules. See, when you write something, you cannot write for your own wish anything and everything. What is the major concept? What you have to focus on? First of all, you have to think what you are going to write, on what concept you are going to write, and how you are going to present it, and what all the message that you are going to provide for the society, that everything should be there in the written languages. So if you take an example of our English literature authors, they all have followed all these characteristics one, and then only they have written the concept. Okay, even our examples of romantic writers, they will even consider the seasons, the nature, everything to give certain meaning to the readers. So similarly, they have a plan, they have an idea how they have to communicate or what they have to convey to the readers. So when you write something, or in the written language, all this social role should be play a very important role. Okay, next, the punctuations. In the spoken language, when we need to convey our messages, it could be easily understood by stress and rhythms and phrases that we use. But in case of written language, only the punctuation marks will give the clear idea what the writer is actually writing about. So these are the basic characteristics of a written language. The first one what we saw is the final draft status. Next is the density of content. Then the grammar. After that, the neutrality of social roles and punctuations. These are the basic characteristics of a written language. Now we are going to see about the similarities between spoken language and written language. There are some common similarities between this language. Let us see now. See, we can see that both the spoken language and the written language are having some similarities. Okay, so when we let us see what all the similarities are there. Spoken and written varies from one social situation to other. See, whether it is going to be a spoken language or whether it is going to be a written language, according to the situation, both the languages has the ability and capability to change according to the situation. Is it clear, girls? I hope that it will be very clear for you. Just listen. Spoken language and the written language is having the ability to change according to the social situation. For example, if you're going to talk with your friend, you'll talk in a different manner. And a conversation between two friends also will be different. But a conversation between you and a higher authority, both in the written and in the speaking form, what will be there? What it will be there? It will have some dignity of words, but it will not be the formal of words will be there. So that is what we are seeing as a similarity of spoken language and the written language, is that it varies according to the social situations. Mode is the way or manner in which something occurs or is expressed or done. So both the languages, both the spoken language and the written language, are having a very clear idea in expressing their own ideas and emotions. Whether it is in the spoken language or in the written language, with the help of punctuation marks, we will be able to convey the idea of the expression or the feeling of the writer to the readers. Similarly, in the spoken form also, with the help of rhythm, stress, we and phrases and passes, we can convey our information to whom? To the listener. So field, according to the field also, according to the situation also, the language, both the spoken language and written language, just get varied. Tender is nothing but the highest of the ordinary adult male range. So to the extreme tenor or to the extreme range or to the highest range both the languages can come up. Okay, so these are the sum of the similarities that we are seeing in this slide. Here is a very beautiful definition or a very beautiful clear idea about what is called as spoken words or what is called as a written words. Okay, the spoken words are the symbols of mental experience and written words are the symbols of spoken words. See, spoken words are the symbols of mental experiences. So what the mind is actually experiencing or what the mind is actually trying to explain to us. So that is what is called as a spoken words. That symbols are called as a spoken words. But the written words are the symbols of spoken words. So written, the spoken words are the experience of mental words. But the written words are the symbols of what? The spoken words. So what, both the spoken language and the written language or the spoken words and the written words are correlated each other. Now we are going to see some of the features of spoken language and the written language. See the picture carefully. Authentic, analytic, free and controlled. In all this concept, in this four concept, you are going to see the features of both the spoken language and the written language. Authentic in the meaning, not a copy. Okay, so first we'll look at the spoken language. Listening to authentic speech for comprehension. So when we read or when we listen to somebody's voice, that will help in speaking. So that is what they are mentioning here. Come on, let us see in the writing language. Reading authentic text for comprehension. So we are in the spoken language, we are listening, and in the written language, we are reading. So these are the major difference that we are not copying, not a copy, but we are listening or we are trying to understand that and we are trying to export to somebody else. What is analytic? Analytic listening uses authentic text, for example, language puzzles. For example, with the help of language puzzles, many times when we try to improvise your English spoken language, we used to give language puzzles or many other words like that, mainly for listening. Am I right? So for the spoken language, we usually, whether it is authenticate or whether it is analytic is nothing but the concept used to express, the major concept that we are trying to express. So in the analytic method, the person is actually listening to the authenticate text to develop the concepts. While in the written language, analytic reading is used. What is used? The analytic reading is used. In the spoken form, the listening is observed, while in the written language, reading is being observed. Okay, free. Next, the topic that we are going to discuss is free. Production of oral language for the purpose of real communication. Production of oral language for the purpose of imaginary communication. So, in the free means, the spoken language, we are using it for two concepts. The first one is the production of oral language for the purpose of real communication. See, we are producing an oral language for what purpose? For the purpose of real communication.
and what not, the production of oral language for the purpose of imaginary communication. Spoken language, we are taking it for two purpose. One is for the real communication and the other one is for the imaginary communication. The written language, when it is free, the production of written language, we are using only when we are free in the written language, we are used to only write about that. So controlled in the concept of spoken language, when we see is that mimed conversation rebuilding. So gaming, mime gaming, or dumb-shared games we used to play in the form of spoken languages, so that will help us to control ourselves. Okay, grammar games, everything will be there in the form of written language. Close, you fill in the blank structured, analytic reading and writing activities can be followed. Revision of students produced text. So this all can be called as a controlled one. For example, that class test that you write is also in the controlled manner. The exam that you write is also in the controlled manner. So these are the some of the features or some of the basic characteristics of what? The spoken and the written language. Now, as we have seen the similarities between the spoken and written language, now we are going to see about the difference between the spoken and the written language. The difference between the spoken language and the written languages are, written is usually permanent. So, what type of the written language, how it will be? It will be usually permanent. And written in text, in what type of form we will be writing? It will be written in the text and cannot usually be changed once they have been printed or written out. So once if we have completed writing about the written languages, we will not be able to change it again. But in case of spoken language, it is not the factor. Speech is usually transmitted unless recorded, and speaker can correct themselves and change their utterance as they go along. So speech, unless and until if you are going to record it, other than that, the speaker can at any time, he or she can change the language or change the words or change the vocabularies, everything, if they find any fault. But it is not the case of the written language. So next point what we are going to see is that a written text can communicate across time and space for as long as particular language and written system is still understood. See, a written text can communicate across time and space as far as the particular language and the written system is still understood. See, only the written language, the written text, we can, how we will be able to understand? We will, for example, if you want to read something in Malayalam, you should know the basis of that language, you should know the alphabets of that language. Only then what you will be able to do? You will be able to write, you will be able to understand the writing of that particular language, and then you will be able to understand the message. But this is not the case in where? This is not the case in the spoken language. Speech is usually used for immediate interaction. Speech, spoken language, what we do know, we usually have an immediate interaction, and if there is a language barrier between anybody else, we will try to make them understand at any cost, so that whether verbally or non-verbal communication, we will be able to make the other person to understand. This is the difference between the written and the spoken language. And we have some more differences also. Let us see that also. The next differences are, written can make use of punctuations, headings, layouts, colors, and other graphical effects in their writing text. Such things are not available in speech. So when you are going to write, we need the people to understand, or we need the people who are the readers, they have to understand, means we have to follow certain structures for writing a language. They are punctuations, headings, layouts, colors, and other graphical effects are also used for the writing text. Such things are not available for what? Such things are not available for a speech. Speech can use, that is speech in the sense they call it as a spoken language. Speech can use timing, tone, volumes, and timbre to add emotional context. So now what we will do in the spoken language, we will usually use timing, tones, volumes, rhythms,
in between phrases also to express our emotions and thoughts. That is the major difference between the written language and the spoken language. The next similar difference that we are going to see is that some grammatical constructions are only used in writings, and as are some kinds of vocabulary and some are complex chemicals and legal terms. Sometimes, so this is the concept what we use for the written language. Some grammatical constructions are only used in writing. Only very few grammatical constructions are used. For example, some science technical words we used to use. When they write max technical terms also, they used to have some legal terms for writing that. But some type of vocabularies are used only or mainly in speech. Only some types of vocabularies are used. Very limited number of vocabularies. When we write, no, we will find more number of vocabularies. But when we are going to read something, when we are going to deliver something, only very limited number of speeches are used. This includes slangs, expressions and tags, etc. So this will include what all things it will be included. It will include the expressions through which we will be able to communicate, or through which we will be able to convey the message to the others. So these are the major differences between the spoken language and the written languages. Now we are going to see in this particular slide the main differences between the spoken language and the written language. See, the spoken language, right? So the main difference is, first of all, we are going to see sound versus letters. Where we will use sound? We will use sound in spoken language. Where we will use letters? We will use letters in the written language. Next one is that permanency. Permanency means thing that is permanent. For example, the written language, that is very, very permanent. But redundancy means you're just going to, it no longer needed. For example, the spoken language, how? No, we'll just talk and it just moves out. Once if you're not going to record the spoken language, there is no recording it out of. But whereas in the written language, it is recorded and the thing that is kept for permanent. The next thing what we are going to see is that formality and functions. See, there will be certain formalities, there will be certain restrictions for the written language, but that not be the case for the spoken language. We'll enjoy it. We will really have fun in the spoken languages. What are the vocabularies and sentence? We'll give more importance where the vocabularies will be given more importance in the written language, but more number of sentences will be used in the spoken languages. Strategy means a plan of action designed to achieve something. So both the languages have that strategies, because what we are thinking out, that we have to convey to somebody else. So that is a strategy. So that strategy is being followed in both the languages, both the spoken language and the written language. Okay, so interaction between the listener and the speaker. So these are the two main common case between the spoken language and the written language, because whether it is a written language, we are writing that the reader has to read, so the listener and the speaker. Similarly, between the spoken language also, we are one is the listener, the rest one is the speaker. They are communicating each other, they are trying to convey the message to each other. So these are the major differences between the spoken language and the written language. In the slide, we are going to see some example for both the spoken language and the written language. See, the first example, a written note might say, would you like to go out to lunch? So how it will say, would you like to go out for lunch? This is the format that we will be using in the written language. So you already know that in the written language, you will be using punctuation marks and you will be very formal in their writing. But the alternative person, we have the other example. A person who would write that note might alternately say in person. So the person, see, we are taking an example of a same person. A person who is going to write that, would you like to go out for a lunch? But the same person, if he is going to speak that same sentences, how he would say,
you want to go out for lunch. So can you find the difference between both the spoken language and written language? Same concept or the same message was to be delivered, but in the way of writing it is entirely different, and in the way of speaking also it is entirely different. So this is what we all need to understand between the spoken language and the written language. Now we are going to see about the sound patterns in the spoken and the written language. We write slowly than we speak. Am I right? This is a very, very, very important point. We write slow than we speak. Once the utterance is spelled, there is no way to take it back and it dies in the wind. Unlike the written form, it's a document and can be shifted. So what they're telling, so the written, they're talking about the spoken language is, no, once it is uttered, it is moved or it is gone away. But in the case of a written language, it is kept as a document. It is moved from one place to other. In spoken, you must know the sound system of a language. So few things that you have to know for both the spoken language and the written language, they are, you must know, first of all, we are going to see about the spoken language. You must know the sound system of the language. What you should know? You should first of all know the sound system of the language. You must also know how the sound change in fast speech. So even in the fast speech also, how the sound is being changed. English sound system varies. So what they are telling, actually the English sound system is getting varied. In written, we replace the passes. Intonation we have already discussed, that is the pronunciation or the free way of talking or how we have to talk, and the intonation and the hesitation that shows the speech in the punctuation in writing. So in the written form, we need to see the punctuation, rhythms, intonations, everything has to be there, because only through that we are going to convey the message to the readers. One who read our text through the writing, no, only to them they, we are making them to understand. So this are the major patterns, or these are the major differences or major common things that we should know when we are going to analyze about the spoken language and the written language. Through this diagram we are going to, or through this picture we are going to see the few of the very important aspects of the spoken languages. First one, what we are going to see, spoken language is a spontaneous and instant. Spontaneous means continuously and without any thinking, on the spot we will be able to talk. Spoken English gives the opportunity to rethink or rephrase and utterance. So what does the spoken language do to us? Spoken language helps us in rethinking and rephrasing our utterance. Once we have talked something wrongly, we can take it back again and we will be able to talk. And the spoken language is an interaction whether the both the participants are present. So spoken language is abled, or spoken language is capable, or spoken language is done only when we have another participants along with us, only then we will be able to listen. And the spoken language tend to use informal vocabularies. We don't want to sit and search in the dictionaries for the more number of vocabularies for what? For the spoken language. The spoken language, the interpretation and overlapping are common. Common, see, very, very common. See, when we'll be talking, somebody will talk in between us, or some other miscommunications will be there in between both of us. So this both are very, very common factor in the spoken language. Spoken language characterized for the beginning the dynamic and transient. So it has been characterized in a dynamic manner. So these are the very general characteristics or very general features about what is called as spoken languages. Now we are going to see about the written language. Written language, there are compact expressions due to their careful sentence structures. So in the written language, what we have to see? We have to see about the compact expression due to what? Careful sentence structure. We need very, very careful sentence structure should be there for what? For the written language. And the written language is, the writer is usually distanced from the reader. So in the spoken language, what we need? Only when two persons are there, the spoken language plays an important role. But this is not the case in the written language. What happens in the written language? Writer is usually distanced from the readers. And it is also, that is, the written language is also non-visual and non
immediate feedback. We will not be able to get an immediate feedback from whom? From the person who is going to read our work. Written languages uses formal vocabularies including the words which are not normally used in spoken. So usually you take an example of a poetry, the author need to convey something to the reader, a messageful thing he has to convey, but at the same time if you find the vocabulary, you know, it will be very very difficult. Am I right? Yes, it will be very very difficult to convey. So the vocabulary that we use normally will be entirely different when compared with the spoken language vocabularies. And the written language, there is a time lagging between the production and reception. So once a reader need to publish a book, the writer might write it for more than months, 2 months, a year, something like that. So, but it is not the case in the spoken language. What we talk, we produce it immediately, and the person, one who is near to us or one who is listening to us, they will listen it and they will reply it fast. So there is there will not be gap between the person who, one who is talking with each other. But this will not be the case in word. It will not be the case in the written language. Okay, so the next point what we are going to see about the written language is that punctuations plays a very very vital role in the written language, because only with that we will be able to convey the message to the reader. So only with the punctuation marks, only with exclamatory marks, we can make the reader to understand what the concept actually they are discussing about. So by this class, I think you all could have a clear idea about what is called as a spoken language and what is called as a written languages. The spoken language is nothing but the language that we speak is called a spoken language, and the language that we write is called as a written language. Both the languages are very very important. Both the language has its characteristics, similarities, differences, everything. And through this video, I think it will be very clear for you what is called as spoken languages, what is called as written languages, what are the difference between them, what are the common factors between them. So thank you for listening to this video. Thank you.